High School Crossfire is brought to you by
Light It Up. Light It Up. Light It Up. Light It Up.
And
everybody's smiling. Skin God is for everyone.
But if in a place like Uganda, even if the president decides to announce for the next term, well, he is allowed.
POI.
He failed actually to
point of information.
Not taken.
This is the High School Crossfire. Welcome back.
I was talking of the point of view being biased. No, it encourages voters to stand up for their candidate since the voters are not sure of who is winning. This is because no one knows who is winning. Today, the public opinion poll brings out that Besigye is winning. Tomorrow, it comes out that Museveni is winning. Museveni supporters will always stand up for elections to show that they want their candidates to what? To win. However, away from that, allow me bring you some of my points and heated views that are straight and straight to points. This is number one. Public opinion polls grant us freedom of expression. Freedom of expression freedom of expression comes out from our own very own constitution that says that anyone is allowed to express and do whatever he wants. By participating in public opinion polls, we are allowed to express our feelings, what we know. Not for someone to tell us what to do or what to be told or what to be done. That is denying us rights. Example in France, we are denied rights. They also provide useful information to the politicians. Example, Honorable Jimmy Akena of Nira District had a problem of roads. His roads in this ruin were very poor. And after the public opinion polls, he came and reckoned on these roads. Right now, if you go to Nira, a case study, or hit a joke line, you will find one of the best tarmacs in Uganda. I'm telling you, just the truth and nothing but the truth, I'm just on this. It increases voters' turnout, that is, the number of voters that are going to turn up for elections are going to be higher because they want to check on and they want to prove right or wrong the political opinion polls. Thereby, if I'm a voter, I need to turn up. If they say Museveni has 57 and Besigye has 21, I need to turn up and see whether that public opinion polls results was just and was up to date. So I need to turn up for this. Thereby, this comes out from the Daily Monitor of February 26th.
Thank you, our honorary judges. My name is Senkai Marvin Ezra, representing St. Joseph's SS Nagalama. We are the farmers, and I'm here to present my points of clash. First of all, our dear August House, I do not want you to be deceived by these denigrators. For example, the leader of opposition came here and said, proudly, that the particular sampling is what is required in the constitution, because she said that by sampling the minority and the minority should represent the majority. Yet the constitution requires that we get the ideas of the majority because it claims that it is for the people, government is for the people, the people. Even the definition of democracy says that this is a government of the people, for the people, and by the people. I also continue on to say that the leader of opposition said that they help the government. True, 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 true. And this is where you prove our point. They are a form of bias. Imagine the incumbent president, Yoweri Museveni, did not know that a certain place was his weakness. And an opinion poll is conducted, and he gets to learn that that place is a stronghold of his key rival. He will go ahead and put in more effort to get the votes of that place. Don't you realize that that is biasing the votes? Don't you realize that on the election day, that will sway the votes more to his favor against the key rival? That is what we mean by bias, August House. Ladies and gentlemen, the second negator came here and continued to drown us in lies by saying that it was an opinion poll that was used by the president by then in the US, Bill Clinton to make the current act on terrorism known?
Point of information?
Please. Granted.
Yes, indeed, it was the public opinion polls. I direct you to the website www.quora.com for further information. Be updated.
And what
please.
Does it say, sir?
I've said it already. Why should I repeat it for you?
What
are you
saying? Say?
No.
And I would say that he is not sure of what he's saying. He just simply probably fabricated the website. They presented a point and said that the elections and the opinion polls, not granted, the opinion polls are indeed credible. But, ladies and gentlemen, according to Zukin, they say there once existed in the US a research group, a research organization called Research 2000. That carried out research under a contract by Daily Kos, a newspaper in the US. In June 2010, three independent amateur statisticians, Mark Grebner, Michael Weisman, and Jonathan Weisman, began investigating Research 2000's numbers, suspecting that they could have been fabricated. And indeed, on June 29th, the Daily Kos released the findings of that investigation, which concluded Research 2000's data and showed its extreme anomalies inconsistent with random polling. With that, we as the farmers continue and strongly say that these opinion polls are indeed inaccurate. According to our resources, Timothy Karegeya, who said in the Daily Monitor of Sunday, August 2015, that InfoTrack research and consulting firm gave statistics accounting to 107%, 107%. Ladies and gentlemen, keep that as food for thought. With that, we the farmers conclude and say that political opinion polls are indeed a burden to this country and hence should be banned. With that, I rest my case.
Chivuka Ashraf, Kakugulu Memorial, protocol observed. First of all, I'll start with the first speaker. You talked of the opinion polls being inaccurate, but let me tell you something. A well-conducted opinion poll can be very accurate. It's stated that a sample of 1,000 people can accurately reflect the views of more than 200 million people. According to the Chicago Daily, it says that polling is a statistical science with established literature and the publication of organizing of ongoing research. You people are talking about bias, but the opinion polls are meant to get the different views. They are not meant to bias. Good enough, the third speaker came up here and said that President Museveni, in case he knew that there was an area of weakness, he would actually work on that area so that he could win. Yes, I would also support this, because the opinion polls have helped him keep in track, and after he has heard of the opinion polls, he can actually improve his weaknesses so that he can provide better services, maybe to the state.
Point
and therefore, I would strongly allow that the opinion polls should not be banned. Are you aware that banning of the opinion polls damages the image of the government? Why would the government ban opinion polls? Because these opinion polls actually criticize the wrongs of the government. Do you know why France has banned them? No. The people were criticizing the French government. So what did the government decide to do? To ban them. And you see what's happening in France. They're exchanging presidents each time and then. But a country like Uganda, where opinion polls are carried out, we have had a stable government. The president has allowed the opinion polls to take place. And whenever the opinion polls take place, things are looked upon. Take an example. Roads are being constructed each day and then. Why? The opinion polls. People have been asked what they want, and they are like, Mr. President, we want roads. Roads are being constructed. Four schools are being set up. Those are the UPE schools. Therefore, I would like to inform the August House and the members of the affirmative side to please allow the opinion polls be carried out in the state. I remain Chivuka Ashraf, Kakungulu Memorial. Thank you.
This is the High School Crossfire. We'll be back in a minute.
High School Crossfire is brought to you by...
Light it up! Light it up! Light it up!
And...
Everybody's smiling. Skip God is for everyone.
But if in a place like Uganda, even if the president decides to announce for the next term, well, he is allowed. actually taken
point of information.
Not taken.